May we all turn to our Bibles to the book of Matthew, chapter 4, verses 1 to 4. Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward hungry. And when the tempter came to him, he said, If thou be the Son of God, command that these stones be made bread. But he answered and said, It is written, Man shall not live by bread alone, but by the very words that proceed out of the mouth of God. In this passage, Satan is trying to deceive Jesus and try to get him to lower his guard and his authority. But Jesus noticed what was going on and stood for what's right. In a song, there's these six words that say, You make me drop my guard. And every time I hear these words, I listen to boxing matches where you gotta keep your hands up and keep your guard up. And in this passage, Jesus noticed this and put his defensive stance on and put his posture on. We can't be afraid just when the devil comes at us and say, Oh no, here comes Satan. He's going to hurt me. I must give up now. I must surrender now. We have to put our fist up and stand on the word of God alone.
Amen.
Even if we walk down the path of righteousness, there will be roadblocks and there will be obstacles, such as girls or guys and guys, girls, music, movies, TV, so many other things. But we must stand in faith and God hates us, don't throw at us. He will try to deceive us, but we have to put our fist up and stand on the word of God, and by faith we shall overcome. Galatians chapter 2 says, But when Peter was come to Antioch, I withstood him to the face, because he was to be blamed. If we just switch Peter's name to Satan, and the verse is from our perspective, it will say, But when Satan came into my life, I was scared to withstand him to the face. But we needed to say, But when Satan came into my life, I withstood him and I confronted him. He was to be blamed for ruining my life. And it stops here. We need to put our fist up and we need to protect ourselves from this world. We need to stand for what's right, but we might get knocked down, but we got a Lord of Lords and a King of Kings.
Amen.
In Genesis chapter 1 verse 3, it says, God said, Let there be light, and there was light. If we have a God that says, Let there be light and there's light, we obviously have a God that can say, Arise, my child, stand up, and we shall arise. The devil will try to deceive us and tell us we're no good. I'm telling you, these are all lies. We have to put our hands up and stand on the word of God. We need to stand for what's right in the Lord. We have our own personal trainer and our own guide that we carry around with us every day, the word of God, the Bible. I challenge you today to stand for what's right and live down the path of righteousness.
Amen.